that feminist theory can help us understand, but I will let this aside for the moment for the discussion if you want to go back to this. So what I will do mostly is to show why the Republican conception of freedom as non-domination is irreducible to either negative freedom or positive freedom, and explain why we should favor it over the two others. So my communication will proceed as follows. I will first go back to Berlin's definitions of negative and positive freedom, so I will remind things that have been talked about already a lot this morning. And then in a second time, I will introduce the concept of freedom as non-domination and explain what makes it appealing. So